And here is the Writer's Almanac for Saturday, the 22nd of June, 2019. It was on this day, 1944, that the Servicemen's Readjustment Act of 1944 became law, a law better known as the GI Bill, signed into law by President Franklin D. Roosevelt, which provided a number of benefits for returning veterans at the end of World War II. Education, unemployment pay, low-interest loans for houses, farms, or businesses. It turned out to be a very popular piece of legislation, but it almost did not pass at all. The House and the Senate fought over various parts of it. Some congressmen didn't want to extend unemployment benefits to veterans. They worried it would stop people from looking for work. Other people thought that veterans would not fit in at colleges, which historically had been attended mostly by children of privilege. But Congress also wanted to avoid the sort of public scandal that followed World War I, when in 1932 poor, hungry veterans marched on Washington to demand the bonus that had been promised to them, and federal troops had to be brought in to force the World War I veterans out of Washington, D.C. So the bill passed, and it was a huge success, especially in the realm of education. In 1947, 49% of students admitted to college were veterans. Many colleges, from Stanford to the University of Georgia to Rutgers, nearly doubled the size of their student body. Of the 16 million World War II veterans, almost half of them took advantage of education programs. Before World War II, a very small percentage of Americans attended college, about 15% of people between the ages of 18 and 20 were enrolled. Most of those were from well-to-do families. And so people were surprised after the war when the veterans turned out to be very successful students. Joseph Heller, author of Catch-22, went to NYU on the GI Bill, as did Frank McCourt, the poet Lawrence Ferlinghetti. Norman Mailer studied at the Sorbonne in Paris. It's the birthday of Yosef Paparovsky, born in Brooklyn, 1921, who became the producer and director Joseph Papp, who founded the New York Shakespeare Festival and the Public Theater. And it's the birthday of Harriet Mulford Lothrop, born in New Haven, 1844, who wrote under the pen name Margaret Sidney, The Five Little Peppers and How They Grew, about a young widow with five perfect children. It's the birthday of the novelist Eric Maria Remarque, whose novel All Quiet on the Western Front came out in 1929. He'd been drafted into the army at the age of 18, suffered severe injuries fighting on the Western Front. The book was banned by the Nazi regime in Germany. Remarque came to this country and wrote nine more novels. It's the birthday of Billy Wilder, born in Austria, 1906, came to this country in the 1930s, got a job writing scripts for Fox, worked his way up the ladder, ended up producing and directing some great movies, Double Indemnity, Seven-Year Itch, Some Like It Hot, and The Apartment. Billy Wilder, who said, an actor entering through the door, you've got nothing, but if he enters through the window, you've got a situation. And it's the birthday of Senator Elizabeth Warren of Massachusetts, born in Oklahoma City, 1949. Her mother worked at Sears. Her dad was a janitor. She graduated high school at 16, got a scholarship to George Washington University, married a NASA engineer, enrolled in law school at Rutgers, got interested in bankruptcy law, and became the advisor for the National Bankruptcy Review Commission, from which she developed the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. Here's a poem for today by Barbara Crooker, Field with Wheat Stacks, Vincent van Gogh. He fell in love with a simple field of wheat, and I felt this way too. melted like a pool of mint chip ice cream, foolishly in love, even though we know how it turns out in the end. Snicked by the sigh, burnt in the furnace of the August sun, thrashed, separated, kernel from chaff. But right now, it's spring, and the wheat aligns in orderly rows, yellow-green, snap pea, sage, celadon, his brush strokes pile on, wave after wave, as the haystacks liquefy, slide off the canvas, roll on down to the sea. A poem by Barbara Crooker, Field with Wheat Stacks, from Les Fauves, published by CNR Press and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.